Zimbabwe for our first story. ZANU-PF youth leader Kudzai Chipanga says that the army is selectively reading the country's constitution and should be confined to the barracks.
His comments are in reaction to yesterday's news conference by Zimbabwe's Defence Force commander. So it's upping the ante. General Constantino Chiwenga said that the Defence Force would step in if the ruling ZANU-PF party continued to purge veterans. Today, Chipanga issued his warning.
Defending the revolution and our leader, the president, is an ideal we live for, and if need be, it is a principle we are prepared to die for. From the outset, we would like to make it clear that we have every respect for the armed forces in this country and cherish their role in protecting and safeguarding the country and its revolution. We, however, totally against the bulk of the press statements issued by General Chiwenga yesterday. We believe that the views he exposed are his personal opinions and not the collective view of the security forces.
Now, the army, as we've been saying, is warning that it will intervene if President Robert Mugabe continues his tactics in an effort to help his wife succeed him. Earlier today, reports emerged that four tanks headed towards the capital, Harare. Well, we now speak to our correspondent in Harare, Effort Musekiwa, just to get a sense of what people are saying that they saw, that they're posting on social media. Is it real? Is it not real? Well, let's catch up with Effort, who's in Harare right now. Effort, thanks for joining us. So social media has been abuzz throughout the day today with images of tanks apparently going towards Harare. What can you tell us about those images and if there's been any activity by the army at all today?
Good evening, Peter. Yes, it's true. The social media was abuzz today with images, video clips, people taking pictures, people posting all over Twitter and Facebook and WhatsApp. It is true that, yes, there were reports that some tanks, four of them, left Nkomo barracks, headed from Harare. But we understand that they were heading to the Presidential Guard, which is just on the outskirts of Harare in Zivarasekwa. So they just moved from one camp to the other, not necessarily that they were making a move or taking any action against President Mugabe.
Is it unusual to have this kind of movement of tanks going to the Presidential Guard?
I spoke earlier on to some political commentators who said because the general yesterday spoke of instability and that the military would step in, it might be an indirect indication that the army is on high alert. So if they are on high alert, they might, you know, do such moves. So really, it might be just because of what the general said yesterday regarding the instability in ZANU-PF and the anxiety within the nation. So really, until we get an official position from either the military or from the government, at the present moment, it's all speculation as to why they were moving from that one barrack to the other.
What sense do you get about the situation in Zimbabwe right now? We had the general yesterday make this declaration that he would intervene if necessary, and then this morning a very defiant ZANU-PF youth league. So it's almost as if battle lines are drawn between supposedly the two factions.
It's clear that battle lines have been drawn. I think this has been ongoing for quite a long time now. You will recall that about 2 months ago, President Mugabe actually warned his generals not to interfere in politics. And the platform that he chose to warn them was actually at a youth rally. So now that the generals have actually again made a public statement, it's the youth who have come forward to defend the president. So it is very clear now that the battle lines indeed are drawn, tensions are high within ZANU-PF, and if you listen to the Army General's address yesterday, he was talking of party politics, not necessarily national politics. He was talking about the ruling ZANU-PF party. So really, it's really clear that there are factions within the ruling party that are actually at war with each other.
All right, we've run out of time, but Effort, perhaps one last question. Is the general in charge of all the armed forces, or is there a split between the army, police and the air force?
Okay, the general is in charge of the Zimbabwe Defense Forces, which comprises mainly the Zimbabwe National Army and the Air Force of Zimbabwe. And during his address yesterday, he was actually flanked by commanders from both the army and the air force. And they fall under the Ministry of Defense, which was at one point was headed by Emmerson Mnangagwa before his elevation, before he was appointed Minister of Justice, then his elevation to Vice President. Then you have the police, it falls under the Ministry of Home Affairs. So it was not represented in that meeting yesterday. And the police have not yet even issued or made their position known. So it's what's known is from the Ministry of Defense or from the armed forces, which is the Air Force and the Army. They are the ones that have made the pronouncement.
All right. Effort, Mr. Kiwa, we're going to leave it there. That's our correspondent in Harare saying that, yes, there were movements of tanks, but perhaps not unusual, especially given the comments that were made yesterday about